What's up? I'm going to review what Freelee eats on her so-called frugivore diet. I bet she wishes that that was a head.
Cool, that's amazing.
This one fell.
Hey Frugivore, I'm Freelee, welcome back to the Frugivore channel, and welcome to new viewers from John's channel Obese to Bit.
Okay, the first thing I see here is that she's trying to imitate cooked foods. This is why she switches from raw to cooked. I've been eating only raw food for almost 5 years now, and of course, those have been mostly animal foods. You can't eat raw, man-made plant foods.
Peace, by the way. Great to have you here. Okay, so today's video is highly requested, and that's what I eat in a week on the frugivore diet. So I'm back on raw living foods with no cooked dinner. And if you're interested in a video about why I'm doing this, what's a comparison, that sort of thing, then definitely vote on the video, whether it's a thumbs up or a thumbs down. And of course, I still recommend the raw to four diet and eating cooked plant foods for those of you who would prefer to do that. But this is just what I want to do because I love it, and it's probably what I'm going to do the rest of my life. Okay, frugivore.
That's obviously nonsense. And the reason she does this is because when you gotta cook your food, it's as if you're admitting that you're not eating your natural diet. Of course, she's gonna quit probably pretty soon.
You have to hang around for this. These are some of the most beautiful meals, some of the most beautiful foods in the world. A lot of food that we eat is from our food forest, and as you can see, a bunch of passion fruits, there's endless passion fruits, lots of jackfruits at this time of year. We've got some sugar bananas and also some ice cream bananas. So it's an awesome thing to do, is to grow your own food, nourish yourself.
Okay, so we got this crispy melon. Mm. It's good. And Sophie is using his hands.
Hey, what the? No.
That's a prime spot here.
Basically, what she's eating there is water with sugar. There's no way that you can eat this and ever feel in any way satisfied. It's impossible.
The sweetest part.
That's how the monkeys do it. He is like a true frugivore.
Yeah, they eat man-made fruit, sure.
So depending...
Monkeys actually eat a lot of unripe fruit, and that's because they convert the fiber into fat because they have the digestive tract to do that. When humans eat a lot of fiber, their gut simply hurts because for us it's indigestible. They don't eat ripe fruit for the most part on purpose. There are of course cases where they oversugar themselves and act like alcoholics.
In the season, some days I start with melons as a pre-breakfast, if you will, because they are quite low in calories. They're highly nutritious, but they also are high in water, so they don't...
How are they nutritious
like
in any way at all?
We have several coconut trees that we harvest from, and we love starting the day with young coconut water and flesh.
Coconut water is hydrating, and if you don't have access to blood and the raw milk, then it actually is a pretty good option.
So it's been over 3 years that I haven't been removing my body fur, and my partner doesn't either, so why should I? You know, it's honestly really freeing. So here I am planting some sugarcane, which is one of my favorite juices, sugarcane juice. Just pop it in, wait for it to grow, harvest, and then enjoy as a juice, or you can chew on it and it's great for your teeth. Great source of fructose and glucose and magnesium, iron, calcium, manganese, some amino acids. Also has fiber, so it's a great juice.
It has probably hardly any fiber, obviously, because it's juice, just the micro particles, basically. But anyway... She says, a great source of fructose, glucose, okay, sure, sugar, that's pretty obvious. But of course, there's no vitamins, nothing to speak of. It's super typical with vegans, they just can't admit or name anything, which is why they just completely ignore it.
To drink. So on this day I had carrot juice, which is rare for me, but we had a whole bunch of carrots, so I decided to juice them. I do like to have food with its fiber because it's important for your microbiome health, for your blood sugar levels, so including the fiber is important, but sometimes I will have a juice. Who else loves my macadamia ring? It's
That's
made
because
out of macadamia
your gut
shell.
Would hurt
it's
too much
butter.
If you would eat
on Instagram. You should
fiber all of the time.
So depending on the time of year, this is a pretty standard breakfast for me. We've got some banana smoothie with maybe 6 to 8 bananas with some dates in there and also some papayas that are generally from the food.
This is complete starvation. It's going to lead to infertility. No woman on earth should ever follow this crazy whatever you can call her this is exactly why she showed those imitations of cooked foods at the start of the video, and those are really just signs that she's craving animal foods.
Food forest.
Oh, jungle pineapple.
Jungle.
Look. Look at the color.
Has the next, ooh, the next pineapple's coming here.
Yeah. Baby. Oh, look at how easy that was.
I think that's one of the most beautiful ones.
Wow.
This year.
I think so.
The color is amazing.
Yeah. Okay, here we go. Off the property. That wasn't down the middle. Oh, wow. Oh,
beautiful.
That does look beautiful.
Okay, these are our bananas, sugar bananas. Papaya off the property.
All bananas are sugar
like
bananas.
Like apricot jam, so sweet. So at this time of year, a lot of our meals are made up of jackfruit because we have so much of it falling. It's a great fruit. So jackfruit is known to be the largest edible fruit in the world, and it is rich in nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins, minerals, and phytochemicals. And the fruit itself...
Wow. Again, she can't name any vitamins because there are none. She says protein. Okay, what? Name something. Phytochemicals, that means plant chemicals which are toxic to humans. There's no benefits. Those are also not nutrients. Why even mention that word? You can clearly see that they, vegans, they have no idea what they are talking about. Or I think that in this case, she on purpose doesn't mention anything because she knows that there is nothing to mention. The way vegans do is that they say it's rich in nutrients at best, or maybe then she names something but doesn't actually say anything. She just vaguely says protein, blah, 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 but doesn't name anything.
Elf, the leaves of the tree and the bark of the tree have also been used extensively in traditional medicine for wound
fruit
healing,
is some of the least nutritious food there is. It's not even food. It's fiber, sugar, and water, very few minerals.
So here's a pretty standard meal of jackfruit for me for breakfast, lunch, or
just not food. Not for humans, anyway.
Wow. Amazing. Of our tree.
So every tree's fruit has unique flavor, but a lot of people say it tastes like bubblegum in general. So that's what you're missing out on. Meals of tutti frutti bubblegum. So in general, breakfast
it's not a
lunch
meal, it's
is
not food.
Simple, large mono meals of delicious fruit. And that's exactly how I want to eat because I can taste every flavor in the individual food rather than mixing it up and just being all confused. But when dinner rolls around, I tend to get a little bit more creative with my salads, mix some more foods, make it, you know, just experiment because raw living foods have the full spectrum of flavor. The enzymes, it
looks
just,
like she's craving cake.
It honestly just blows me away the flavor spectrum that you can develop through combining these living foods. For my green leaf intake, I do have a lot of microgreens, which I've been growing recently, and also katuk from the garden, and a whole bunch of other greens that we grow, Okinawan spinach, sambong, and also mushroom leaf. Okay, so let's get on to these fats.
Completely pointless to eat that. They are indigestible. It's basically just empty fiber that you're eating. Again, no nutrients. She must be incredibly, incredibly bloated from all of this in everyday life. It's absolute torture.
Let's see salads, shall we? And these recipes will be available in my upcoming book. That's all I'm going to say at this point, but stay tuned. It is coming eventually. This is one of my
again meat cravings.
Surprised favorite. Like, oh, just blow me away. Okay, this young coconut. It's a sweet and sour tamarind pasta, if you will. And it is just, it's phenomenal.
Why do you eat raw food if you're obviously craving pasta? And the origins of pasta come from the starvation periods when people had no meat, so they made these grain sludge forms with the tomato sauce and whatnot to imitate blood. This is what people were eating when they were skin and bones, essentially at the end because of the starvation, but they were still trying to eat something because they wanted meat so much, but it was not available. She doesn't need that. That would be bad enough. She's eating raw food, which is trying to imitate noodles, which are trying to imitate meat. Absolute mental illness.
Honestly, one of the best salads I've ever made. So with these salads, I make sure I have enough fruit during the day. So,
what does that look like? Wow. Ground meat. Cooked ground meat pasta.
I'm having at least 2,000 calories from fruit during the day before I have the salad, just so I don't get glucose and fructose depleted. And this is enough.
Just the absolute mental illness. You gotta sit there, not realize what's on the dish, and then eat it, thinking, oh yeah, I like this raw food, this is what I want. Being so super oblivious as to what your senses are actually telling you, that alone already shows absolute brain damage.
Another one of my favorites, which is a mushroom carrot bolognese mix, and it's really good. Like, I'm not talking this up, it's honestly really, really special. And I just realized, being back on raw and back on living foods, that I prefer to eat this way.
It's so special, it's because you crave something and else so much.
It's going to be hard for some of
and this
you
is the closest
believe,
you can find
but
to it.
It has the original flavor still in it. It has
complete denial
added back with a whole lot of salt and, you know, other flavor enhancers. It has the flavor.
And this is durian. It definitely tastes better than it looks. About 1200 calories. Delicious. It's frozen, but it's thawing out. Oh, creamy goodness. Oh yeah, it's good. And marinated mushrooms. Just like lemon juice and ginger, garlic, chili, that kind of thing, and some dill. I just kind of threw the dill in there, so I'm not...
Again, she's trying to imitate cooked and animal foods, and I also like durian, but I wouldn't use it as a meal. That's a snack, because it's a special fruit, and Europeans shouldn't have access to it anyway, but of course nowadays we can get it imported. But she says that it's a creamy goodness, and that's because she's craving animal fat so much. That's why all of the so-called frugivores, the fruitarians, are so obsessed with it, because it reminds them of the cream that they used to eat before they were brainwashed to enter veganism.
Not sure how it's going to be. And avocado salsa. This is a chili jam. It turned out really good, hey?
Again,
I'm really happy with this chili jam.
Red.
It looks delicious, right? And it tastes delicious.
Just absolute meat cravings.
All raw.
She's
all
showing
living.
It to everybody. And most people
That's
don't
it.
Get it.
Gonna have dinner now.
Funny.
So just for full transparency, because a lot of people are like, I'm fully raw, but they don't tell you what they're eating that is actually heated.
Sushi
and
cravings.
This is toasted nori.
Raw
I would prefer
fish.
To have raw, but it's incredibly hard to get. When I can get it, it's just very, very hard. So at this point, sometimes I will have some toasted nori, but it contributes back.
Hey, Freelee, you're severely mentally ill. Do you understand this? You sit there eating all of this when you're really craving animal foods that you used to eat. Who knows when was the last time, and then all of the vegan cooked garbage that you ate after that. Hey, hello, why not sit there and eat your fruit simply as it is, or why not eat the green leaves? Why not just eat it like an herbivore or a frugivore? Why try to imitate foods that you used to eat?
About two calories or something to my diet. So these are the delicious stuffed nori rolls. And
if you don't get it, you clearly don't enjoy or even want any of this.
It's another incredible dish. And make sure you don't try and get all your calories from the salad like you would say from a cooked pasta dish, because it has far more carbohydrates in it. So that's why I add in a lot of mangoes. I'll have like 4 mangoes sometimes in this salad. So you just make sure you get enough.
It's super disgusting.
Stay on this path.
Look at the color!
You can taste the sugar just by seeing
wow.
it. It's way too much.
This is so rich.
It's just gonna lead to heart
this
disease.
This is a pasta made with yellow sapote or egg fruit. It's just incredible, the consistency and the flavor that you can get with this fruit.
Because
so this
you
is
want to imitate cheese?
Accidentally
Again,
came up with myself by
raw fish cravings. Anything to imitate
really
the taste. Texture, anything.
Of, you know, soy sauce or some tamari. Oh without
boy.
Actually using it, you're getting a fermented kind of...
It's just pathetic,
edge,
really.
But it's also sweet because of the carrot and the other vegetables and some avocado in there. It's a really good recipe. So I don't usually go to this much effort, but this night I did. I went all out and I made a lasagna. There's quite a few layers there. We've got some like mushroom carrot mince. So it was a bit of a process, but it turned out great. And this recipe is actually available in the set.
Why would you put so much work into imitating those foods? It's because you want... cheese, for example, and the ground meat that they put in lasagna. Wow, if anybody is still watching this who follows her and doesn't understand what she's doing, you're lost.
Second edition, which is out now. That's my video for today. Let us know in the comments below what your favorite recipe was. All right, don't forget to be a good frugivore today and go fruit yourself.
You wouldn't even need any recipes if you were eating your natural diet. You take a food and you eat it. What people's favorite recipe was probably the one that reminded them of the animal foods, or at least the cooked foods that they used to eat. If they now follow a so-called raw foods diet, absolute nonsense. If you eat raw animal foods, which is what we are designed to eat, and not this anti-human diet, then you would never think about all of these recipes because you wouldn't crave anything else. The reason you crave other stuff is because what she is promoting is malnutrition. That's the only reason. You're literally not getting what you want. Whereas the monkeys that she's mentioning all of the time, they, of course, never think of anything else. They can eat the unripe bananas totally hard. They don't get any digestive issues. They feel perfect. The people who do this kind of stuff are the ones who hate themselves. And because they do that, they also want you to hate yourself. They want everybody basically to hate themselves because life for them is misery. Misery loves company. It's just absolute destruction of humanity, and especially women in this case, because it's mostly women that watch her videos and actually get advice from her. She doesn't tell anybody that plants don't have over 50 nutrients. Of course not. That would destroy the whole image. Thanks for watching.